Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel and please hit the bell icon for instant notification.
Dear students, welcome back to another video of Gravity Point. Today we will perform practical of potentiometer from section A, class 12th. So before getting started with the practical, we will discuss a little thing which is away from the concept of. एक बात बताइए कि बैंक में you are having your account. और अकाउंट का बैलेंस आप जानना चाहते हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई एम दैट पर्सन हु इज गोइंग टू लेट यू नो व्हाट इज द बैलेंस लेफ्ट विद द बैंक. टू कंडीशंस आई एम गिविंग यू. फर्स्ट, जो आपका एग्जैक्ट बैलेंस है बैंक में वो मैं आपको बता दूं. सेकेंड ऑप्शन कि बैंक में जो अकाउंट है आपका उसमें से मैंने कुछ पैसे विड्रॉ कर लिए, कुछ मनी को विड्रॉ कर लिया. And then I am telling you what is the balance left with you. Now, in that case, for example, in bank you are having 90,000 rupees. Clear? और आपने जब balance जानना चाहा तो एक condition है जिसमें कि मैं आपको exact value return कर रहा हूं, बता रहा हूं. Another possibility is I have withdrawn 20,000 rupees and what is the amount left in your account now? 70,000. So these are very two different situations or the conditions. Truly, which method will you prefer? This option or this option? So I am very pretty sure no one will go for this option. जितना भी अकाउंट में आपका बैलेंस है, जितना रुपया है, आप चाहते हैं उतना ही डिक्लेयर किया जाए. And we should not, or the third party should not withdraw any kind of the money from your account. So that is happening in our case now. Because potential difference can be measured with help of voltmeter also. With help of voltmeter, we can measure the potential difference. But what is the problem? Problem is same. कि जब हम किसी भी सर्किट में पोटेंशियोमीटर को लगाते हैं, तो ये सर्किट से किसी भी करंट के अमाउंट को ड्रॉ नहीं करता है. That shows कि ये जो सेल का EMF होता है, ये लगभग 100% हमें बताता है, similar to this example. Whereas, in voltmeter, when it is connected to a circuit, तो ये उस सर्किट से कुछ करंट को ड्रॉ कर लेता है, which results into terminal voltage. And every one of us are aware कि जो terminal voltage की वैल्यू होगी वो सेल के EMF से कम होती है, because we have done this formula. So I am pretty sure कि अगर आपसे वाइवा में या एग्जाम में ये क्वेश्चन पूछा जाता है कि व्हाई डू वी प्रेफर पोटेंशियोमीटर ओवर द वोल्टमीटर, सो रीजन इज वेरी क्लियर. Potentiometer is having capacity to tell you the 100% true value of the EMF of a cell, whereas voltmeter हमें terminal voltage देगा जिसकी की value EMF से कम होती है. So now we will understand the concept of potentiometer. So now look at this circuit diagram. Here we are having the length of the potentiometer wire, that is AB. Always we are making this terminal as a positive one, connected to the positive terminal of battery, cell or eliminator. Another end will go to the negative end, continuing with the rheostat key and coming back to the point P. About this circuit diagram we will discuss later on. We are knowing what is the direction of the current. Current hamesha battery cell ke positive terminal se negative terminal ki taraf along the path move karti hai. So where do we have that path? Ye is tarike se flow karti hui wapas circuit mein aayegi. So as we have assumed, I is the current available in this upper part of the circuit. So can we write down? I is the current in AB wire. Now assume R, that is the resistance of wire per unit length. And small e is potential drop per unit length. Now students, can you correlate these two things first before going to the formula and all? हमने कहा कि I is the current, तो I तो constant current है जो कि flow होगी AB branch में. Small r, this is the resistance of wire per unit length. It shows कि AB की एक कोई certain length है, लेकिन उसकी unit length का resistance कितना होगा? For example, we are taking this is the unit. So what is the resistance of this unit length? Small r. What is the potential drop available here? That is small e. So will you write down by the Ohm's formula as we are knowing V equals to I R. That suggests equation number 1. Why do we have this equation as E equals to I R? Because EMF of the potential drop of how much length of unit length? I, that is a constant current, R smaller because that is the resistance per unit length. Now you suggest me, do we have any variation in the value of I for a particular reading? जब हम practical करेंगे तो उसमें समझेंगे, we will take 3, 4, 5 readings. लेकिन कोई भी एक reading जब लेंगे तो उसके लिए current की value क्या होनी चाहिए? Constant. It means for a particular observation, this value is kept as a constant. What is happening with the R? R is also the resistance per unit length. तो वो भी constant होगा, ये भी constant. So can we conclude E, that is the potential difference of per unit length, that will remain constant. Now we will go further. हमने क्या किया कि एक ब्रांच में इसके पैरेलल में एक वोल्टमीटर कनेक्ट किया. हमें पता है कि वोल्टमीटर शुड ऑलवेज बी कनेक्टेड इन पैरेलल. जब हमने इसे पैरेलल कनेक्ट किया देन डेफिनेटली इट विल टेक अ लिटिल अमाउंट ऑफ करंट थ्रू इट. अब हमें ये क्या देगा? पोटेंशियल ड्रॉप देगा. यहां पर ए से जे तक की लेंथ को अगर हम स्मॉल एल माने तो हमारे पास जो स्मॉल ई वेक्टर था या स्मॉल ई जो क्वांटिटी है वो हमें क्या बताती थी कि पोटेंशियल ड्रॉप है पर यूनिट लेंथ का। तो एल लेंथ का पोटेंशियल ड्रॉप कितना होगा? तो बाय यूनिटरी मेथड, अगर हम इस कॉन्सेप्ट को बिल्कुल नहीं जानते तो बाय सिंपल यूनिटरी मेथड यू कैन कंक्लूड कि अगर एक यूनिट लेंथ का पोटेंशियल ड्रॉप ई है, एल लेंथ का पोटेंशियल ड्रॉप वी है, देन हाउ आर दे कोरिलेटेड? वी इक्वल्स टू ई एल। आई एम क्लियर, आई होप सो। अगेन आई एम रिपीटिंग, ई जो है वो पोटेंशियल ड्रॉप है यूनिट लेंथ का। हमारे पास में लेंथ कितनी है? एल। तो कितना पोटेंशियल ड्रॉप होगा? सो वी कैन एड अप वी इक्वल्स टू ई एल। Now, here E is constant, therefore V is directly proportional to L. So that is principle, that is the observation taken from the potentiometer, that the potential difference is directly proportional to the length of the wire, और ये एक point होगा जहां पर हमें नल पॉइंट मिलता है। नाउ व्हाट इज द स्टेटमेंट? द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस बिटवीन एनी टू पॉइंट्स, वेयर आर द टू पॉइंट्स ए जे ऑफ अ वायर ऑफ यूनिफॉर्म एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द लेंथ ऑफ द वायर बिटवीन दीज टू पॉइंट्स प्रोवाइडेड द करेंट थ्रू वायर रिमेन कॉन्स्टेंट। सो रेस्ट कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ दिस वी विल बी हियर। So just as students, we have understood what is the principle of potentiometer. It was concluded up to V directly proportional to length. Now, get some theoretical aspects of practical. Section A, experiment number 5. To compare the EMF of two given primary cell, one is Daniell and second is Laclanche. So, we have assumed that E1, EMF of Daniell cell, E2, EMF of Laclanche cell. Standard value, आप याद कर लीजिएगा, जो Daniell cell होती है, उसकी लगभग 1.1 volt होनी चाहिए, और जो Laclanche cell होता है, that is having the standard value as 1.4 volt. Now, come to the circuit diagram. This auxiliary circuit will remain as it is. हमें सिर्फ क्या करना है कि दो cells जो हमें दिए हुए हैं E1, E2. Again, connect these two things. E1 जो हमारा bottom में जुड़ा हुआ है, वो कौन सा cell है? Daniell cell है. Laclanche, E2. उसके बाद में हमने इन दोनों cells में one way की connect की. Its name is K1, K2. उसके दूसरे टर्मिनल से जो दो वायर्स आएंगे, मेक देम कॉमन, कनेक्ट वन टर्मिनल टू गैल्वेनोमीटर एंड अनदर एंड इज कनेक्टेड टू जॉकी। यहां पर प्लस और माइनस की और क्लियरिटी के लिए इन कंटिन्यूएशन जब हम आपको डेमोंस्ट्रेशन दिखाएंगे प्रैक्टिकल का, देयर यू कैन वेल अंडरस्टैंड, बट वी आर टेकिंग द थ्योरी एस्पेक्ट ओनली। यहां पर जैसा देख सकते हैं कि डैनियल सेल का जो ईएमएफ है वो Laclanche से कम है, तो हमें क्या करना है कि हम सर्किट में केबल को क्लोज करेंगे और टाइमिंग के लिए K2 की निकाल लेंगे। That shows in a given circuit which cell is involved, E1 is involved, और हम मान लेते हैं कि वो हमें null point कहीं J dash point पे देता है जिसकी length L1 है। So what can you write down by this principle? We can write down E1 directly proportional to alpha. That is equation number 1. अब हमें क्या करना है कि केवल की को ओपन कर ले और K2 की यह पिन हमने इंसर्ट कर दिया, तो now E2 is in circuit diagram. E1 सर्किट से बाहर आ गया, क्योंकि केवल की को आपने निकाल लिया है, none of the current will flow through this branch. Now again, we will get null point. Now the question is, why have we shown this null point on the right side of J dash, not on this side? The reason is very clear. As we are knowing, potential drop is directly proportional to length. और यहां पर हमें यह भी पता है कि लैग्रांजे सेल का पोटेंशियल ड्रॉप या ईएमएफ डैनियल सेल से ज्यादा है, तो करेस्पॉन्डिंग लेंथ भी जो आनी चाहिए नल पॉइंट के लिए वो एल1 से ज्यादा होगी या कम होगी? ऑफ कोर्स ज्यादा होगी. एंड दैट इज अ रीजन वी हैव शोन दैट नल पॉइंट ऑन द राइट साइड टू द जे डैश एंड दैट इज जे. सो व्हाट कैन बी राइट आउट? ई2 डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू A2. That will be equation number 2. Now dividing equation number 1 by 2, you will get, and that is the formulation for the comparison of EMF. If just we recall, the value says 1.1, 1.4, so this should be the result at the time of the practical or nearby. So this was the way how are we going to conduct this practical, and we will see to it that how close we are coming to value of 0.8 volt. So here we are going to get a start with comparison of the EMF of two given primary cell. One is Lagrange and second one is Daniell, using potentiometer. So already we have gone through the circuit diagram of potentiometer for comparison of the EMFs of the two cells. Here we can see eliminator is having two ends, positive and the negative. Positive terminal will be carried to the lower end of potentiometer. Now with negative terminal of this eliminator, you just connect negative of emitter as per the circuit diagram again. Take positive terminal to the current divider. From the voltage divider, you take one wire which is making another end of the potentiometer as negative one. So that is called as auxiliary circuit. Now begin with cells. Two cells we have, and we are assuming EMF of Daniell cell is E1, EMF of Lagrange cell BS E2. Here positive role is done by carbon and here copper. Take these two wires and make this point as a common point or the positive. Always do remember, zinc rod is always treated as a negative one. So we are taking zinc rod of both Lagrange and Daniell as negative one. And these two wires will be connected to one end of the key, another end of the key will go to the negative end. So here, as we are doing rods, they are always treated as a negative one, zinc rod. Take these two points with two different terminals of the key. Another ends of the key will be connected to positive of galvanometer, and negative end will be connected to jockey. So first you will have to establish either do we have the correct connections or not. For that you check deflection. Here we can see in galvanometer we are getting right deflection. And here it comes on left. That shows in between somewhere we will get the null point. First we will introduce Lagrange cell. and take this key out. Right. It's still right. So it's better to move on the fourth wire. So here we have null point. So again, put this piece of paper to get the accurate value. So this value is coming on the fourth wire. It means 300 plus 46.9. So this value is 346.9. So better to write down in our observation table. Left anchor cell 346.9. So as per our record, this is the value of L2. Now take this key out. Introduce another key and put this zinc rod in pot. Now again verify the deflection on the both side. Right, 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 again left. It means null point is becoming before to that. So here we can see this reading is 301.8. This value is 301.8. Take this rod outside. So value was 301.8. And we can also write down the value of the ammeter here. The value is 160. The ammeter is showing you milliampere, so reading will be given as 160 milliampere. As per the rule of the EMF, comparison of the EMF, the formula is L1 divided by L2. So on division, ratio will come out to be 0.869. So as that is very close value, because we are doing tentative value of EMF of left anchor cell is 1.4 and deviation is 1.1 volt. So when you will divide these two respective values, the ratio is coming out as 0.8 volt, and our result is also very close to 0.8694.